Hey Virgo, it's Trishna here. Welcome to your December 2018 reading. What I'm feeling for you in December is I think that there is some stress that is carrying over from before November. So in the November reading, we talked about how there's something that was stressing you out that you're letting go of and you're going off to like new opportunities and you're excited about it. Whatever that stress was is what I think is actually stressing you out in December. There's something from your past that had an impact on your life, and as a result, it is still impacting you now, even though I don't think that you were actually dealing with the same people or you're interacting with them at all. It's just the memories of it because there's an energetic impact that happened to you, and that is not unusual. There's nothing wrong about that happening to you. Things in life just have impacts on us, and sometimes we need to work through them a little bit more than we would like. And so I feel like there is a stress that's still carrying over into December, and I feel like it's coming up because there's something you're excited about moving towards in November that maybe isn't working out in the way that you thought it would, or as quickly as you thought it would, or even at all. And the thing that I want to say about that is sometimes it takes a little while for things to make sense. Sometimes it takes a little while for things to work out and show their benefit to us. We don't always see the immediate gift in the things that are coming to us or that we're going after or that are approaching us. Sometimes it takes a little while for us to really understand the value that lies behind it. So I really want you guys to keep that in mind, as if things aren't working out for you the way that you thought that they would, give it time. Like you can't measure things so quickly. You need to let things grow and become what they're supposed to become. Don't be so rushed in trying to get the benefit or the gift or the results. And remember what we talked about in the last month is there are going to be little hiccups. And it's really important that you stay present in the moment and that you don't try to find the meaning into, did I make the right decision? Why did I make this decision? Why isn't this working out? Is this here to teach me a lesson? No. Just give it some time. Just relax. Just give it some time. If there's a lesson that you guys need to have, it will come to you when you ask. If it takes a little while for the lesson to come to you, then wait. It will come to you later. So that's one of the things that I want to tell you guys. Okay. So the other thing is that you guys have this stress coming into your life, and it's probably because something that you thought was going to work out didn't work out the way that you had envisioned it was going to work out or as quickly as you wanted it to work out. This month, you are given a choice. You are given a choice to be happy and enjoy the holidays, or to feel bitter and be crabby and to not enjoy the holidays. The holidays are a time when the energy is very, very, very potent because there's a lot of energy going on, there's a lot of thoughts in the same direction. Whether it's everybody wanting to buy gifts, or it's everybody ready to spend time with their family, or it's everybody dreading spending time with their family, whatever it is, there's a lot of similar thoughts going on at the same time by a lot of people. And so it makes the energy very, very potent. And then also with the holidays, it just naturally adds in this positive touch to all of it and this positive feeling. So the energy is very potent. It can go in any way, but there is a casing of very positive emotions to it as well that kind of can pull you in that direction if you allow it to. And that is why you guys are being given the choice this month. How are you going to enjoy the holidays? How are you going to enjoy this month? It is a choice that you have to make. And that how we receive that potent energy of the holidays really depends on where we choose to be on the happy, unhappy spectrum. If you're closer to the happy spectrum, if you're like past the 50% point on this side, then the happy energy is going to pull you in and allow you to really enjoy the holidays. You're going to like the music, you're going to like the decorations, you're going to like the energy, the feeling, the people being cheery. If you're on the other side, the unhappy side, or like more on this, like even if you're in the middle, but you're like more on this side, it's going to pull you into why do they keep playing the same song over and over again? Why are they playing these songs so early? Why is everybody so cheery? Why do I have to buy these gifts? Oh, I hate buying gifts. Why are the malls so filled with people? That's what you're going to experience, you know, versus somebody who's happy is going to be like, oh, I love all the people, you know, in the malls. It just makes the energy even stronger, and we're all just here enjoying it. Everybody's nicer to each other. Like, you get to decide where you are in the spectrum, and that's going to help you choose how you're going to receive the energy, the very potent energy of this month. So the choice is yours. And the guidance that I get for you is go find your mom. If you're having a hard time feeling happy, go find your mom. Okay, so, and there's a few little sub rules to that because there are people who did not grow up in a family that had good parents, or people who don't have their mom in the physical plane anymore. Their mom's off in the spirit world. So that sounds kind of fun. Your mom's off in the spirit world, having fun. But you don't have a physical mom that you can really rely on here in this lifetime right now. So there's some things around that. So if you have your mom, go find your mom. Seriously, go find your mom, because your mom, mothers have this amazing healing energy about them. No matter how much they can push your buttons, because you guys were together for 9 months in one body, so your energy is very, very entwined, very, very close. So you guys know how to push each other's buttons like nobody else. They also have this healing energy because they were healing you, they were growing you for those 9 months, and then their energy is just powerful. Mothers just have a very, very powerful energy. It's like Mother Earth, it's like Mother Nature. Just very, very powerful. It's moms are able to bring something from just an idea into physical reality. Like, they're the pure manifestors. They're just the epitome of manifestation, like manifestors, creators. They truly created life. So go find your mom, because your mom is going to help you feel so much better. Even if she annoys you, she is going to make you feel so much more healed, so much better. She's going to set your energy. I don't know why I'm feeling emotional right now, but she's going to align your energy in a way to where you can have the best of December, where that choice of are you going to be happy this month or are you going to be bitter this month, it's going to make that choice so much easier. She's going to pull you to that happy side of the spectrum so you can receive this potent energy in the best ways possible for you. If your mom was not a great mom, like if you just were born into a family where that just isn't the case, or if you've lost your mom and she's passed away, go find another mom. Go find your friend's mom. Go find your grandmom. Go find somebody who has that nurturing quality, who can share those nurturing feelings with you, even if it's not your own mom. Because again, moms have very, very powerful energy. It works best if it's yours, but their love can be like, if it's your friend's mom and that mom cares about you, you will get the same benefits as well. So go do that, because I just feel like, I don't know, it's just the guidance I'm getting for you. It's really important that you do that right now, this month. And I don't know why I'm feeling so emotional about this. I guess it just means that you guys really, really need to do that. And yeah, that's all I'm getting about that, is go do that. And they will set you on the right track. They really will. Energetically, I think also mentally, I think not only will you feel better, not only will you feel more healed, I think you will have some kind of clarity of thought that comes out of that discussion or just that time together. Just go do that, guys. So I hope this is helpful. I hope you guys take my advice. Tell me how it goes, how much better you feel, and all of that good stuff. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video with anybody who you think it will help. Again, thank you for watching this video, and I will see you guys in my next one.